everyone, welcome you all to Imagination Gallery. Here we try to show you different types of drawings and stories behind it. So if you are an art lover and wants to know the unknown facts, press the subscribe button now. Now let me introduce you to today's topic. Today in our Africa series, we will talk and illustrate about the place famous as the home of former South African President and Nobel Prize winner Nelson Mandela. It's Eastern Cape, South Africa, and we will also know about Xhosa people there. So watch till the end to experience this amazing journey, paintings and stories on Eastern Cape and Xhosa people. So friends, we have seen so many aspects of Africa here, isn't it? From tribes to village life, from street murals to different tribes, their home, their culture, colors, patterns. Imagination Gallery tried to bestow all relevant details of every aspect of Africa. And today, on our 32nd part of the series, we are going to Eastern Cape, a mountainous country on South Africa. We are going to take a quick look on Eastern Cape's Xhosa people and South African railways also. Using acrylics on paper, I've tried to, create the best possible representation of this beautiful place. So let's begin the journey. My bosom buddy, let's know about the Eastern Cape. The Eastern Cape is one of the provinces of South Africa. Its capital is Bishop, but its two largest cities are East London and Port Elizabeth. The Eastern Cape as a South African province came into existence in 1994 and incorporated areas from the former Xhosa homelands. Climate is highly varied there. The west is dry with the sparse rain during winter or summer, with frosty winters and hot summers. There is much fertile land there in the Eastern Cape, and agriculture remains important. The fertile Langkof Valley in the southwest has a large deciduous fruit orchards. In the Karoo, there is widespread sheep farming. Now, friends, it can't happen that you're in Imagination Gallery and we couldn't talk about art. No, that's not gonna be happen. So, wherever we go, wherever the country we visit, art discussion will always be there. So from visual art studios to galleries, theater, dance, world class stage productions, the Eastern Cape hosts a variety of first-rate cultural events and exhibitions, including the National Art Festival in Makhanda, that is Grahamstown, appealing to art, music and literature enthusiasts from all four corners of the country. When you think of heritage in the Eastern Cape, a few things came into mind. It is a melting pot of extraordinary diversity. There is a rich cultural heritage of the Xhosa and Xhosian celebrating traditions, food and beliefs. There is the natural heritage firmly rooted in the abundance of flora and fauna. There is heritage of art and also of historical importance, reflecting on bygone eras, people and institution. And it is all there, just waiting to be explored and shared. So Amaya, we are doing. There are over 200 heritage sites in the Eastern Cape alone, ranging from museums to houses, churches, farmsteads, old stations, schools and courts. So what about the Xhosa people? Hosa, formerly spelled Xhosa, is a Nguni ethnic group living primarily in Eastern Cape Province, South Africa. They form part of the Southern Nguni and speak mutually intelligible dialects of Hosa, a Bantu language of the Niger-Congo family. Traditional healers of South Africa include diviners or should we say Amaguria. This job is mostly taken by women who spend 5 years in apprenticeship. There are also herbalists, they call it Amak Sawel, prophets, they call it Janus, and healers for the community. The Xhosa have a strong oral tradition with many stories of ancestral heroes. According to the tradition, the leader from the whose name the Xhosa people take their name was the first king of the nation. Traditional crafts include beadwork, weaving, woodwork and pottery. And about the music, traditional music features drums, rattle, whistles, flutes, mouth harps and stringed instrument, and especially group singing accompanied by hand clapping. So that was kind of a very, very, very short gist of the Xhosa people there in the Eastern Cape, living there in the Eastern Cape. So I just want to share so much things and about everything, wherever the place I'm talking about, all the details. But in one session, it's really impossible to do so, you know. So just kind of trying to give the gist of it. Now, what about the South African Railway? I said that we will have a quick look about that also. And the reason why we are talking about the South African Railway, why I am sharing this discussion, is because a major part of this painting featuring a locomotive steam engine, it is about the train station. It is major part is of this painting is about the train station and the steam engine. That is why we are talking about it. So like any country you go, of course a very major part plays by the very major part of the transport, public transport, is played by the railway. So does in South Africa as well. Rail transport in South Africa is an important element for the country's transport infrastructure. All major cities are connected by the rail, and this South Africa's railway system is most highly developed in Africa, and rail industry is publicly owned. The first railway was from Cape Town to Wellington and was worked by a small locomotive in the year 1859. And a popular scenic view you can take in Eastern Cape activity, that's an Eastern Cape activity, is the Apple Express steam train trip from Port Elizabeth to Thornhill, where you can take a scenic views from the highest narrow gauge bridge in the world. So that was again a small gist about the South African railways. My bosom buddies, the Eastern Cape is one of the South Africa's most underdeveloped provinces. It can provide visitors with an experience of untouched Africa. With its rolling hills, vast coastline, forests, areas of semi-arid desert, Drakensberg mountains and diverse flora and fauna. The Eastern Cape has a rich cultural heritage as well. Located along the coast are the traditional Transkei and Siskei regions, the home of the Xhosa people and the birthplace of the former South African president Nelson Mandela and Thabo Mbeki. There is so much to explore in Africa, and we all want to go to a place, or we want to know about a place where there is less people, where there is no much chaos of the people, and such kind of a place is Eastern Cape. So this part of South Africa, friends, waged between the well-known Western Cape and KwaZulu-Natal is largely ignored by a lot of people, by the tourists. Despite being one of the poorest provinces in South Africa, it has a wealth of riches to offer visitors in cultures, history, scenery and wildlife. So well, as I say, there is so much to discover in Africa. We will know the lesser known things about Africa, and we will do that, continue doing that only for you. I know you are with us as well. Let us be one family. Let's color the life with Imagination Gallery. I hope you enjoyed and liked today's journey to Eastern Cape and Hoza tribe. Transmit your feedbacks and suggestions about our drawing session here in the comment box. Write it. If you like our drawing session and you want to know about different paintings and the stories behind it, then do not forget to subscribe our channel. Here's wishing you an amazing week to continue. Stay safe and take care. Bye-bye.